another shorter video here. We need to go full blast right now, because if not now, when? We don't want to wait until there's some kind of announcement in the world that, guess what, we've made contact with extraterrestrial civilizations, because that is going to grip the imagination of the planet in a way that is nothing has ever gripped it. And at that point in time, if we are not solidly grounded in what is most important to look at, we'll easily get, the current will carry us off. It is like a massive flood or a tsunami. If we're not in higher ground, that tsunami is going to sweep us away. So how to get on higher ground? Here's a further explanation of that. The problem is, again, we don't feel we deserve to get onto higher ground. But what is it that doesn't feel that way? Belief. See, belief doesn't believe that we're deserving to have a problem-free scenario. But belief will never believe that, because belief is entirely geared towards solving problems. And so belief doesn't believe there's any such thing as a problem-free scenario. Therefore, it says, you can't possibly deserve that. You can't possibly deserve it. So literally, we have to go beyond belief. It's not belief that can see it, that can know it, that can accept it, that can realize it, that we are deserving of that. Belief cannot do that for us. So why don't we go beyond belief? Because we want to keep belief. We want to stay on the good side of belief. We want to have belief in our back pocket. In case annihilation does happen, we want to be able to turn to belief and say, belief, you're my savior, and you're going to save me from this annihilation just by believing in some alternative scenario. So we are very hesitant to go beyond belief. Basically, what everyone does is they accept the best that belief can believe in, which is why you have a lot of the whole spiritual teachings and realms and teachers. Most of it is within the context of what belief can believe in. But belief cannot believe that we're deserving to literally dwell in a problem-free realm, in a death-free realm, that we can experience a perfect overlay of everything. It does not believe that for us. It says we can't possibly be deserving, meaning I'm not able to believe in that. That's what it means. When it says you're not deserving, it means belief cannot go there. So we have to go beyond belief. And the fact is, we are absolutely deserving of this. Again, we want to stay on the good side of belief, because just in case, we're hedging our bets, right? We're trying to have it both ways. We say, well, what if reality was annihilated? What will we turn to? Oh, belief. So we've made up this power called belief, and we believe, and this power supposedly is going to save us from annihilation. So we don't want to go beyond belief. We don't want to, for belief to feel like we've deserted it, or literally, we don't want to see beliefs, the folly of belief, that it's insane, that it's nothing. We don't want to see it. We want to believe that there's something to belief. And so in order to kowtow to that, to accommodate this, we want to see that there's some power to belief. We refuse to go beyond belief and accept what we really deserve. And therein lies the trap. Therein lies the stumbling block, the obstacle that we just cannot seem to get past. We try. And at least when we're talking about it like this, it's getting closer. It really is. Because at least we're focusing on it. And we're saying, how are we going to get past belief? And so it's not that we're far away. It's just simply there's that last part. I can call it the last 5 pounds. I'll title the video The Last 5 Pounds. Again, when I went on a diet, I got to a point where I'd really lost a lot of weight, but I needed 5 more pounds, and I just couldn't do it. But finally, I found a way. And then, boom, it's gone, and even more. So it is those last part of the path where we say, okay, we've gone as far as belief will allow us to go, and then we need to recognize, no, we're still in the problematical realm entirely. And we haven't accepted the invitation to the problem-free realm. We haven't, when we accept the invitation to that realm and we're still here in this world, we experience it as an overlay. Okay, let's make this clear. While we're still in this realm, if we accept the invitation to the problem death-free realm, we experience it as an overlay here. Everything is overlaid equally perfectly. And then when we actually leave this planet, this realm, this dimension, and go to relocate to the problem-free death-free realm, then we experience that. which is everything there is even more profound, I would say, than the overlay. Or perhaps I don't know how to say which is more profound, really. But while we're here, we can experience the overlay. That's a sign we've accepted residency in the death-free, problem-free realm. And we're going on the path towards accepting reality as it is, and we're making huge progress towards that. So again, to go over it again, prior to any announcement of contact with extraterrestrials, which will happen, it could happen any day as a matter of fact, they keep saying it's going to happen, it's going to happen, it's going to happen. Well, it is going to happen, no question about it. How it will happen, on what day, I don't know. It could be today, it could be tomorrow, it could be any day. Prior to that time, prior to also crises arising, which is very likely to happen, we have to be very grounded in what we deserve and in this issue, of focusing on this issue, very grounded in that, of being reassured that it's okay. And the more grounded we are in that, the easier it'll be to just dismiss this news. It's old news. For me, it's totally old news. Oh, ETs, tell me something I don't know. Okay, they've been here, as we know, all along in this planet. They've always been here. Sometimes more covert, sometimes more overt, sometimes. And so what? They're here. Of course they're here. We know what they're all about. We know what they're up to. We know the basic outlines is all very clear. It's really old news. It's old news. Nothing here. Move on, so to speak. But the world won't see it that way. And when you're surrounded by this tsunami of interest, and everyone's imagination is riveted, it becomes a very tough thing to stay away from it. And what can happen is you have a reaction formation and you go into a shell. That's not good. That is not good. You need to stay fluid and loose and light and happy and positive and focused on something that is way more important. You can't go into a shell. You can't shut down. You can't, isolate yourself from the world, so to speak, and react to that. That will bring about problems for you. So you can just smile and say, "Oh yeah, that's great. That's kind of old news. I know, but whatever. But I've got something else that's even bigger news." And the world is celebrating, you just say, I've got even bigger celebration going on. So that is why I kind of want to get a celebration going on. I really do. So you can just say, yes, but I have something better. That is the right way to handle it. If you just say, resist it and say, fight against it, or say, you guys are crazy, you shouldn't be paying any attention to that. People look at you like, you're really antagonistic. But you can just say, hey, all right, that's cool, that's really cool. But I've got some even better news, or the celebration's going on, which it will, and you can say, yeah, that's a really cool celebration's going on, but I have an even bigger party to attend, even bigger celebration. Let's say there's a huge party going on that's super important, everybody that's anybody is there. How do you turn down an invitation that you will ostracize yourself, feel ostracized? It's not a good dynamic to get into. But if you say, wow, I'd love to attend. That's so cool. So thank you for asking me. But I have prior engagement with another party. It's like even better. I have something, a prior engagement. You see that? How that works? It works like a charm. It works like a charm. I want you, everyone here, to have that. There has to be a smart way to deal with what's coming up. And you can say, I have previous reservations with a prior invitation I accepted for to a even better celebration, so I'm not able to attend, sorry. And you handle it that way, and people just kind of, okay. They don't know. It's a better way to handle it. It is a better way to handle it. I have prior reservations to an even more fabulous party, and I'm following another news story that's even more important. And they'll say, what? Really? More important? Huh? And maybe it will help those around you, for them not to be so obsessed about it, right? So it's a chain reaction where it comes beneficial to the world. So we need to have a party going on. We need to have a celebration going on. We need to have the news going out. Whoa, what a beautiful sunset. Wow. Oh my gosh. That's amazing. The whole sky is like soft, glowing pink. That's very rare here. Very rare. Yeah. We need the celebration going on. Maybe I need to get it going on, or just to kind of prep the thing. Like, you know, there's one that when you go to a concert, which I've been to very few, but I know there's like a set of bands. There's an order of bands. There's the first band, a warm up, then a second band, you know, then a third band. And the headliner comes on. Usually there's a band before the headliner comes on that kind of get the crowd into it a little bit, settle them down, and then they know that people are going for concessions and moving around, saying hello to everybody, how's it going, and they're not really into it yet, but starting to get into it. So it's like a warm-up band. That's what's necessary. It needs to be a warm-up situation where you kind of get into the mode of, yeah, these videos are a type of warm-up, but they're preliminary. I can do better. I can do something better that gets people into the mode of, hey, we're following a better story, and we accept an invitation to a better celebration. And then ultimately, when they say, yeah, but this is 4D, we're going into 4D, you say, I'm actually accepted residence in the problem-free, death-free realm. So thanks for 4D, it's blessings to you, but I have previously been accepted. So those three steps, following a better news story, attending a better celebration, and having residence in a better locale, those three items are key for us right now. So going forward, let us see if I can focus on those. I don't know. I never know what the day will bring. I stay completely open and flowing and free to whatever it is happens. But those three, let's focus. See if we can focus on those three. Better news story, better celebration, better locale. Thank you very much, but we had previous engagements, and blessings to everyone. Smooth. See? It's smooth. Very great. That's it. I'm going to take a look at the sky now.